Hey Cozy Homies, welcome back to the zone. So today we are at Li Kuang Chin National History Museum, and I'm so excited to like actually check out this museum. So I heard there are like a few sets of like dinosaur skeletons in this place, and I really cannot wait to see them because I am a very big fan of dinosaurs, like ever since I was a child. So like my whole childhood, right, it's just me reading like these, like, you know, those dinosaur dictionaries and encyclopedias where they tell you everything about their names, their lifestyle, their eating habits and everything. And I believe like one of the reasons why we all love dinosaurs so much as kids, right, is because of how it kind of fulfills our childhood fantasy and imagination with all these like big names and very weird looking colours and like the shapes of their bodies. They're just so captivating to like the childhood mind, and I believe it is very exciting for me to finally look at real dinosaur bones for the first time in my life. And today we have a very special guest. And here he is. Hi, Jonathan.
Hello. Hi.
So yeah, we all love like dinosaurs and stuff, and he loves everything related to biology. So I think it's the best date to bring him along.
Yeah. All right. Hi guys, I'm here to see dinosaur bones too.
Okay, so hi. I guess we just go in, we just check out like the dinosaur bones, and maybe after we are done, we can update and share with you all more about our findings.
All right.
So, see you later.
Hi.
Well, look, this is the first thing we see when we enter.
Yeah, it's a lot of it. It's a lot of bugs.
So like insects, all these are the name of the species, right?
So the number of species, the name like crustaceans, mammalia and all, it's just the name of the big group of the animals. Like you have crabs and lobsters here, Pisces is fish, then
I literally thought it's like the star constellation.
Yeah, so where it got its name from.
Oh, I never knew that, okay. These are all the micro like organisms.
Most
kind
of them at least, I think. It's like everything we don't really know what they are, we just put them in photos.
Sure. Yes.
I know lots of people who keep this in their houses. I think it's called the rabbit's foot fern.
Oh, what does it do? What's so special about it?
I don't know, it just looks nice. And it looks called the rabbit's foot fern because you can see it's the root structure over there. It looks hairy, like a rabbit's foot apparently.
Oh, do you mean this?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Interesting. This little yellowy...
It's reproducing. You can see a little like baby sticking out.
Oh my goodness, so we're actually seeing like them like giving birth in action in a sense.
Yeah, I guess.
Wow. So basically, they say like each branch kind of like branches off to like one species, I guess. Mm-hmm. Then wherever the line ends, it means they kind of gone extinct. So it's like the millions of years ago, so this is getting more and more recent. And I was so surprised that right, actually mammals came before birds. Mm-hmm. I always thought that birds looked so much more ancient than mammals.
Yeah, mammals existed a long time before birds. It's just that the mammals that existed were so tiny and insignificant that I think they're like direct descendants of the dinosaurs. So technically, in a weird way, we are reptiles in a very weird way.
Yes.
Yeah. So, oh, hi.
It's so cool. I'm like, actually this place is like, it looks really like more like new and modern than I expected this museum to be.
Yeah.
Really fun. I learned so much though, like all these like little things, right? They're so informative. I learned so much from all these like signages that they put up. So cool.
Yeah.
Okay, so I was told this is a dead Rafflesia, and I didn't expect it to look like this because the real one looks about like this, and I'm like, ooh, so cool. So when they die, they become like this. It seems like beauty is temporal, nothing's permanent. This is really such an aesthetic, so beautiful. Wow. This looks like something that can come off of a sketchbook. So this is how like rattan looks like. There are like spikes all over them. Ooh, this is painful.
It mimics the appearance of a corpse, so it looks like a dead thing, so it attracts flies to like fall.
Wait, but how does this look like a corpse? It looks so
actually,
beautiful.
No, I mean when you look at it from up to down, it's completely red on the inside.
It's red on the inside.
And you have like, if you can look closely, there are like tiny little flowers and at the base of the bulb.
Are there? Okay, I don't think I can see here, but
you can't really see how this is.
I heard something about like the leading lines kind of like draw insects into the...
Yeah, technically.
Oh, okay.
And another thing that this does, right, is that when the flower blooms, it tends to heat up as well. So it like mimics the presence of a rotting animal. So it attracts flies and stuff.
Oh, okay. I see. It's interesting.
Yeah.
Look at these mushrooms. Yes, you all know Jonathan loves mushrooms. I love mushrooms too. Like, ooh, which of these are edible?
I have no idea.
Damn, okay.
That is a Ganoderma, I think. It's a medicinal mushroom. That, I forgot what they call it in Chinese.
Oh, is it Lingzi or something?
Ah, Lingzi, yeah.
Oh, is it the legendary, like, expensive mushroom?
Yeah, Ganoderma lucida, yeah.
One thing about mushrooms is they're like so colourful and like the shapes are just like so abstract.
Yeah, they look so cool.
Oh, this is so cool. It looks like a sculpture. Oh yeah, I saw this on like Instagram before. You know those like satisfying videos.
Oh my god, it's called Phallus.
It's called what?
The genus name is Phallus.
F-E-L-L-A-S.
P-H-A-L-L-U-S.
Okay.
Obvious reason.
Oh, but the thing is, when it dries, so like depressing though, like what you said.
I mean, you would look pretty depressing if you were dried up too.
What kind of document is this?
They're carnivorous snails.
Oh, how does that work? I've never seen snails eat other organisms before.
Snails have a very, can extend their mouths to pretty large, like...
But what kind of things would they normally eat if they're carnivorous?
Other snails? Fish?
They eat other snails, okay.
Yeah, they have a lot of sharp teeth also. I think they call it radula, like the millions of the tiny little teeth that they grind.
Yep, ooh, grind them up. What a nasty way to die.
Yeah. It's a type of starfish. It's a basket star.
Oh.
So they have like all the little like feathers and stuff that they use to catch like food in the ocean and they drag it down to the mouth in the middle.
Oh, there's a mouth in the middle.
Yeah, so you'll see them like opening and closing.
Oh, so they kind of like pulsate.
Yeah, they kind of pulsate. Oh. It looks more like a plant than an animal.
It's like a snowflake actually.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, what?
Wow.
Oh, what in the world is all this? Ooh, the colours are still there. Ooh.
And an interesting thing about this is that if you look closely, right, the shell of the turtle is part of its skeleton.
Oh yeah, I recently just found out that.
Yeah, so you can't really move the shell of the unlike snails.
Okay. Didn't expect to see something so morbid. Oh, these are the, what's it called? They're like chickens, right? They haven't been born yet. Mm. Oh my goodness, what is this?
I don't know, it's a frog. I think those are eggs.
This looks like it came out of like a horror movie scene.
Yeah.
Oh my.
Yeah, I think this is called a sea mouse. It's like a type of worm, a sea worm. And there's all these sharp bristles along the sides.
Oh.
Yeah, so it's used as a defense mechanism.
These three are kind of related, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, it's a worm.
Yeah, these are all worms.
Yeah, this looks really scary to me. I'm not associating these two to be worms, but this is obviously a worm. This is obviously not a worm.
It's just a worm, but it's flattened.
It has like a beautiful like outfit covering itself.
Yeah, that's pretty neat.
They say when you chop this little thing into different pieces, each piece grows to become its own individual entity.
Yeah.
And something about this just doesn't sit quite right with me. It's quite disturbing.
Yeah, I think you should be able to do that.
Yep. Okay, so I'm 2 years old when I found out that octopuses and squids belong to the same family as snails. I mean, it logically makes sense, but I naturally never made that connection.
Everything is squishy.
Oh, and also there's this number 53-54. It's called the Winged Argonaut. This is such a beautiful name. Yeah, sounds like a kind of sound like Greek mythology or something.
Yeah.
The conch, oh my god, I'm not sure if any of you are like read Lord of the Flies. But basically, Lord of the Flies, there's this huge conch, and I think it looks exactly like this in the movie, and everyone talks about it.
Have you watched SpongeBob? Oh my god, remember the magic conch?
Oh, I literally. You say these are carnivorous?
I'm not too sure about these, but I mean, judging by their size, I wouldn't be surprised if they were actually carnivorous.
Yeah, they're really huge though.
Yeah, they're pretty big. That is. So number 7, Amber Pidgeot. It's a whip scorpion.
Oh. This one like a spider than a scorpion though.
It is in the arachnid family.
Hmm.
It's okay. Neither a spider nor a scorpion, it's in the family now.
Yeah, okay.
Then you have the horseshoe crabs, which funny enough are more related to spiders than actual crabs.
Oh, are you serious?
Yeah. It's the marine spider. Marine arachnid.
Oh, it looks pretty.
Yeah. They grow up to pretty big spiders.
Yeah. So beautiful, especially this, the colours. It's like a,
those are stick insects.
It's like a watermelon.
Yeah.
Colour tone.
Stick insects have wings that look really colourful, but on their own they don't really look like much. I guess that's the point of being a stick insect, right?
Yeah, I mean, here is a stick.
Yeah, I mean, so.
Oh, yeah, we're all like skinny people. If I see any of this in real life, I would like literally scream and run away. So horrible. I love like the blue colours. Oh, this is beautiful.
Oh,
and you're talking about how cicadas have these nice toasted colours.
They look like they've been toasted nicely.
Yeah, I love it too.
These are the pond skaters.
Oh yeah, the ones that stick on the surface of the pond, right?
Yeah, the spiders on the surface of the pond. These things. They're not really spiders, but like, yeah. Okay. Some of these are big enough to hunt fish also, from what I know.
Ew, okay. Singapore's famous for the chili crabs. Look at this.
Making me hungry.
Collection. Oh my.
I bet you could probably like make a really nice meal out of all of these specimens, yeah. I just think.
Yep.
I think these are one of the deepest living animals in the world that we know of.
This good, I don't see them in real life. Oh.
It's a hermit crab.
This cute.
Yeah. Oh, then up here you have the mantid shrimps.
Oh, alright.
You see number 7? Yeah. You see the two like balls that, like hanging from the top?
From the where?
The top of the near the head there. You see like the two clubs thing? The two club things?
Oh, you mean these two?
Yeah, those two things.
Uh-huh.
They strike with one of the fastest speeds in the animal kingdom.
What did they do though?
It hits something so hard that it literally causes the water surrounding it to boil. And light is produced also.
What?
So people who've kept these right in aquariums have been known to like have these like break punch holes into the aquarium walls.
These things are nasty.
Yeah, they're pretty bad. Yeah. Another thing is that they can see almost 9 more colours than we can.
How can they tell different types of colours? Like, what other new kinds of colours that we cannot see that they can see?
I don't know, you try to come up with a new colour.
Yeah, and like, so like, it's just like, what, different types of what, photoreceptors, right?
Yeah, they have more complex compound eyes than we do.
Yeah. Speaking of colours, right, just now he was talking about butterflies and I just hate butterflies for passion, so I didn't. But I think like all this, right, he was saying about how all this kind of like the blues and everything, they actually aren't really blue or green.
The shiny ones are the shiny blues.
Yeah, because like it's just the way the light reflects. And I think something about this is quite interesting.
Yeah, so if you put these blue butterflies into a blender and like you blended them up, you wouldn't find any blue inside the liquid. Because it's just an optical illusion. Something like that.
Yes, it's just all an illusion.
Nothing is real.
Yep. But remember like the ancient Egyptians kind of worshipped like these kind of beetles? I don't know what about that makes them look so sick.
Well, they worshipped many things.
Yeah.
Ants and bees are a part of the same family. Also, in that family. Then for cockroaches, you have termites in that same family.
I mean, they're all like nasty, annoying creatures.
Yeah, awful. Over here you have the flies, the mosquitoes, and the house flies. Mm-hmm. They're all in the same family also.
Mm-hmm.
All also equally as disgusting.
The oldest fishes in the world and still alive and kicking.
It's a dinosaur fish.
Yeah. Damn. Oh, what are these? What are these? Oh, it's like, well, it's like an elephant's like feet. Number 4 is a triceratops. Oh my god, we had that. We put that toy out just now. Also, this is the feet of a triceratops. Of a triceratops.
If you notice, the general plan of all of these legs are the same.
Yeah.
Which is like evidence of how we descended from animals also with like a similar plan. I mean, yeah. If you look at our hands and legs also, it's roughly like follows the same structure as well.
Yeah, essentially, because it's always like this big thing followed by a joint, followed by a big thing, and then for the fingers and toes.
So yeah, the leg of the femur, the tibia, stuff like that.
Yeah. This is beautiful, it's so majestic, look at how big this is.
Look at those legs.
Also, this is the guy that decided to climb out of water and enter land. So, you know, if you didn't come out of land, we would have existed and life would be so much better. I'd rather be just photosynthesizing in the beach. I never knew sea urchins can look this colorful. Mm. Wow, look at that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, this is called a cushion star. I love the name of it.
It's so fat. Look at that. It looks like bread.
Yeah, it does, but I don't think it's actually that squishy. Just...
You took a bite out of that.
Nah, my teeth will break.
What?
I seriously forgot that turtles are actually reptiles too. I failed my primary school science.
It's so smooth, look at that.
Look at all this, like snakes and everything. Oh, goodness. Oh yeah, you're all born in the year of the snake, right?
That explains a lot.
Yep.
I think it's called Draco Cornuta. It's the closest thing to a dragon that we have.
Oh yeah, so it's like
from
a mini dragon.
Yeah.
Oh, so this is like basically this, but like
it's the first bird to have come from the dinosaurs.
Mm.
Yeah, so you can see like it looks a lot like a lizard, but it has feathers coming out of it.
Yeah.
So. Which fun fact? A lot of dinosaurs had feathers, which a lot of us don't know. So things like your T-Rexes and Velociraptors, a lot of them had feathers instead of scales. So The feathers back then were very simple. They don't look like this. We were mostly just like hair like projections instead of scales.
Okay.
So yeah, Narwhal tusk.
Narwhal?
It's a
Narwhal tusk. Oh wait, narwhals are actually real things, right? I always mix them up with
like... Yes, they are real things.
I always mix them up with like unicorns. I realized narwhals are actually real.
Yeah, they're basically real unicorns. You can sort of see how it's really, like you have the nasal bone and then you have like the frontal bone and stuff, which is similar to what we have as well.
Yeah.
It's just different shapes.
Mm, okay. Interesting. What are these? Bats and dolphins and stuff.
It's like you'd never be able to guess what these animals are just from looking at the skulls.
Yeah, I would never be able to guess that. This looks so this looks so satanic, but whatever.
It's a Babi Rusa, I think. Is that what it's called? That is a... This is really scary.
Oh, this is so eerie though,
this
look at
so
this.
This is so scary, oh my god.
This is so eerie, oh no.
Oh, the sun. You know that sun bears actually do look like this in real life?
Oh, they're actually quite cute.
They look like human beings. Like, because of how long their arms and legs are, right? They look the most like human beings out of any other animal.
Oh, are these like human? So this is like us like a few years down the road.
That's us now.
Yeah. This is such a mood. Me desperately like, you know, screaming for my life.
These like humongous giant fruit bats, like they look really really scary like out outside, but like when you look and zoom in on their face, oh my god, look at that face.
it looks less scary than...
It looks like a puppy, look at that.
Yeah. The wings are the scary part though.
Oh. So this particular animal is called a Babi Rusa. It is a very miserable existence because eventually the tusks will grow so large that sometimes they grow into the skull and kill the...
Oh no.
Yeah, so it's a really miserable existence. Yeah,
this is where evolution like backfires on its own.
Yeah.
No, please don't eat me.
The hip bone of the whale.
Oh, never knew that, okay.
Yeah, so it's... One of the pieces of evidence for that whales are part of the mammal species. Also. It's like a mammal or so.
Whales are mammals, right? I always forgot.
Whales are mammals.
Oh, and the teeth look like this. Okay.
Yeah.
Something new. Wow. Yeah, finally, the main star of this entire museum, the dinosaur bones.
Look at all these
sauropods.
Whoa. The humongous
dinosaurs. They're really huge. Look at this. This is Jonathan versus the dinosaurs. Life size comparison.
Oh, what an iconic moment. Finally get to see these dinosaurs. Oh, when you look at them like from
So happy to see them finally. Like, oh, look at this.
You see like the little bone part? Yes.
Yeah, these are huge. Dinosaurs are like, one of the biggest animals that ever like...
Yeah, these are one of the biggest things that have ever existed on land, actually.
Yeah, they're just so breathtaking. Okay, look at this. The head is so small compared to like, their body.
Body shape to a dinosaur.
I just cannot get enough of all this. Like, they are just so huge. Like, imagine though, like a group of this like dinosaurs just chilling in the past. Like, this is exactly what they'll be doing.
Yeah.
Okay, so we finally see
the head.
Yeah, the eyeball though is so cute.
It looks so dumpy. Oh my god.
Yeah, and the teeth is like meh. But they eat leaves probably. Very insane lighting, but hello. Oh my god, can I like, literally have like a heart-to-heart conversation with this dinosaur?
Hi.
Yeah, have you been? How did the meteorite feel when it crashed onto Earth?
Too much different from how I'm feeling right now.
Oof. Okay, bye. See you later. Alright, so we are finally done with our walkthrough in the museum, and like I really learned so much today, thanks to John. I feel like especially coming to like this kind of like natural history museums, right? Like learning about animals and biology, right? It's really good to have like someone that is kind of like knowledgeable in this field. I feel like I learned so much more today.
And if any experts are out there watching, I'm sorry if I said got anything wrong. I may be talking out of my ass for most of the stuff that I just said, but. Forgive me.
Yeah.
I don't do this professionally. I don't learn about these things professionally. It's mostly just like reading and stuff. So please go easy on me.
Actually, right, for you, right, what is the one thing that struck you the most at the exhibition? Like any specific exhibits that made you like, you know?
Just looking at the bones, because like usually we just like even when we look at pictures of the animals, right, you just see how they look like on the outside, but you don't think about what the hard parts of them are on the inside.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's like what you see is not always what you actually is. Maybe there's like some sort of philosophical thing behind that.
Oh!
There's like some sort of like deep lesson.
There's more that meets the eye.
Yeah, again, I'm talking out of my ass. I don't know what I'm saying.
Actually, yeah, I think like just now we had this section where they had just exhibit all the like the skulls and everything, right? Like we really couldn't tell like what animal like those like bones belong to. I think it's the beauty of it actually.
Another thing is that you like you can only see so much on TV and stuff, but like for you to come here and see like live specimens and stuff, like all of the animals and stuff, it's like a different experience, especially for someone who likes reading about animals. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, I think even for me, I learned so much today. Like I finally remembered that turtles are actually reptiles. I found out about like worms don't necessarily look like worms. They look like a million different ways lah. And there are a lot of those very weird animals that are like neither reptiles nor mammals nor whatever. It's just like an in-between of everything. And I think like these kind of animals are really cool lah. I feel like this is what actually drives evolution, right? Like having all these mishaps in nature's experiment.
Yeah.
All the weird products that it created.
Yeah,
kind of. Yeah.
And eventually they ended up with us. So yeah, nature's not always perfect.
Yeah. So I guess next time if there's any more opportunities that can bring him along, we all can like, you know, go and like explore more about this kind of stuff lah.
Yeah.
Like, crazy ideas.
Yeah, hopefully I won't be such like an awkward mess that I am now.
And then again, he's literally like the best person to like hang out with me because we are like colleagues. Actually, I'm not sure if you know. Like, oh, yeah. But we didn't even introduce ourselves. We are colleagues.
Yes.
In NS, we work together with the same shift and everything. So,
yeah.
Like any like schedule, like, we are like the most matched. Like, no one can like, you know, like, yeah. I feel like the level of tightness with you is about the same. Like,
yeah, to be fair, whether we like it or not, we are stuck with each other for 24 hours once every 3 days. So, like, I mean, there are plenty of other people you can have on as well, our shift as well.
Yeah, yeah. So yes, if you want to see more of John, more of my other colleagues, right, just, you know, remember to like, share and subscribe. More content coming out. I'm gonna have lots of like people like coming out and like, you know, just hang around like, and learn new stuff every time we go out. Like. Yeah, so hope to see your comments, you know, if you like this video, please do let me know. And yeah, if you have any insight especially about all this like bio stuff, like just update us because you're very interested to find out more and you know fact check with us like anything.
Yes, please quote me if I'm wrong. I would like to know more as well.
Okay, so yeah, I guess see you another time. Bye.